Hey everyone, welcome. My name is Wes Bunn with Epic Games. And in this session, I'm going to show you how you can connect Maya to Unreal Engine 4 with our new feature, Live Link. Live Link was just introduced in our 4.19 engine release, which came out last week. We're going to show you how you can use Live Link to supplement your existing animation workflow and give you more time to iterate on your content and less time exporting and importing into the engine. So we have quite a bit to cover here and a short amount of time to do it. So very quickly, I'm just going to jump into a quick PowerPoint and outline what we're going to talk about today. First and foremost, what is Live Link and how does it work? We're then going to talk about the Live Link client, which powers sources and subjects, and we're going to talk about what those are. We'll then show you how to enable Live Link inside of Unreal Engine 4 and how to enable the Maya Live Link plugin. Once we do that, we'll be able to establish a connection between Maya and UE4. And we'll also talk about setting up real-time bone remapping and why you may need to do this in your future projects down the road. At that point, we'll be able to real-time preview animation content from Maya directly inside of UE4. We'll also talk about some of the additional use cases for Live Link towards the end of this session and close it out with a quick snippet on plugin development if you're interested in that, how you can extend this to additional applications. So first and foremost, before we jump into what the Live Link feature is, I wanted to take a second to talk about the existing animation workflow. Typically, you're working in your external applications, such as Maya or Motion Builder, whatever your preferred application is. And you're working on content, you have a character, you're animating that character, you decide you're happy with it, you want to bring it into the engine now. You'd go through the export process, export it out as an FBX asset, at which point you can bring it into the engine and see it inside the engine. But at that point, once you see it in the engine, you may have noticed that you want to tweak some parameters of the animation, maybe drop the shoulder or make a facial expression, et cetera. At which point, you would have to go back to Maya, make those modifications, re-export, re-import, see it in the engine, and judge it again. With Live Link, we can alleviate that whole process because you can preview your content in real time while you're working inside of Maya, directly inside of UE4. So we have a quick video. I'm going to show you the feature really quickly before we start working with it. So what we have here is on the left is Maya and on the right is UE4. You can see that we're scrubbing the camera inside of Maya and it's updating the camera inside of UE4 in real time. We're scrubbing through our animation. It's also being updated. You may also notice that we have two different skeletal meshes here. Actually, the one on the right inside the engine is a little bit different. That's because the one on the right is using the same bone and hierarchy information as our character inside of Maya. So we could swap out different meshes as long as that bone hierarchy information is the same. But we're not just streaming data. We can actually change data inside of Maya and see it update inside of UE4 in real time. So this is where you can go in and keyframe different poses, try things out inside of Maya before you do that final export and bring it into UE4. So how does this all work? At the hub of Live Link is the Live Link client. Okay, this is enabled whenever you enable the plugin inside of UE4, which we'll do in a moment. And the Live Link client has two primary functions. One is to manage sources, which is where the source of animation data comes from. This could be Maya, it could be Motion Builder. It could also be motion capture servers. So you can stream in data from a motion capture server into the engine and see that updated in real time. The second thing for Live Link client to do is to manage subjects, the individual streams of data within the client. And this is a character or any other animated skeletal mesh that you want to stream in. So it's really these two things that the Live Link client is going to do for you. So what we're going to do now is jump inside the engine and define a source and a subject so we can start previewing content. Right now we have Maya on the left and Unreal Engine on the right. And I have a character that I'm currently working on from our Paragon assets, just Feng Mao character that has this little attack here. And what we've done inside of Unreal Engine is just exported just the skeletal mesh. So we have no animations over in Unreal. We want to preview our animations from Maya until we're finally happy with them, seeing them in Unreal before we do that final import and export process. So the first thing that we need to do is enable Live Link inside of Unreal Engine. We could do that by going to the Edit and Plugins menu, okay, and then going down to Animation. And down at the bottom, we have the Live Link plugin. Once you enable it, it's going to ask you to restart the editor, which I've already enabled it and restarted just to save us some time, so we don't have to restart the editor. But once you do that, you're going to get access to a new window from the Windows tab called the Live Link Streaming Manager, okay? And when you enable this, you're gonna see the ability to define a source, which we talked about, as well as a subject, okay? So the source and the subject we can define now. We have a little bit of a warning down here at the bottom. It says that use less CPU when in the background is enabled. Do we wanna disable that? Whenever you're working with the Live Link client, you're probably going to want to disable this. Essentially, what it does is whenever the editor loses focus, it throttles it, so you'd have a little bit of lag behind. Since we're trying to preview content in real time, we're going to want to disable that for this particular instance, which is why we give you the option to disable it right here from this menu. So I'm going to disable that. The next thing that we need to do is over in Maya now is to enable the Maya Live Link plugin so that we can start to communicate between the two applications. Now, the Maya Live Link plugin is distributed with the engine, so whenever you download the engine, you already have access to that plugin. You can find it in your engine and extras folder. This is all covered in our documentation pages as well. I don't expect you to remember that, but you'll find it on our documentation pages as well. We have pre-built binaries for 2016, 17, and 18, and we'll talk about some of the additional applications that we support towards the end of this session. But once you extract those files and copy them over to your Maya plugins folder, what you should be able to do is come to the Windows and Settings and Plugin Manager. And once that pops up, you can browse to those files. If I go to my plugins folder, which is right here, and there's the Maya Live Link plugin folder. There's two files in here that we're going to need to enable, the main module and then the UI module that's going to allow us to communicate between Maya and UE4. So I'll enable this one here, the main module, and then I'll also enable the UI. Okay, click open. And we should see down at the bottom that both of those have been loaded and they're ready to go, at which point we could close the plugin manager and we can come down to the MEL console here, making sure that we're on the MEL and not the Python. We're going to enter the command Maya Live Link UI. Okay. Now, this is case sensitive. Again, this is covered in our documentation pages as well. Once you enter that command, if you hit enter, it should pop up the Maya Live Link connection status window. Interesting little side note that I discovered just this morning. If you do not see this window pop up and you've entered in the command correctly and there's no errors, you may need to go into your users folder and delete all of your MEL scripts. I had this happen earlier where the Live Link window did not appear. Interesting tidbit that I discovered during a live demo this morning. So now that we have the Maya Live Link window up, you can see that we have the ability to connect to UE4. And right now it says that there is no connection, so we need to establish one inside of UE4. So over in UE4, we can come to the Add button, and we can go to Message Bus Source, and assign the Maya Live Link plugin. Now, it's using our local machine, but it's interesting to note that you can use networked PCs. So you can have not your local machine, but some other dedicated machine streaming in content. You could do that as well. But we're going to use our local machine for the sake of this demo, so I'm going to click that and click OK. And once we do that, we're going to see that the Live Link window now shows a connection status of connected. We are now connected to UE4, and we can see that over here as well. We also have an editor active camera as a subject. Okay, that's the thing that's going to allow us to control the camera inside of Maya and have it update inside of UE4 in real time. Okay, the last thing that we need to do is add an actual subject that we want to stream over to UE4, which we can do from this window here. Down here in the lower part of the window, we have the ability to add a subject. We can also give it a name. I'm going to give it something a little bit more descriptive than Maya. We'll just call it the name of our character, which is called Feng Mao. And we do need to specify the bone or joint hierarchy that we want to start streaming over. So I'll go ahead and just select the root bone of our character here and click Add Subject. And when we do, it's going to give us see that it's a character that we're attempting to stream over. And over in Live Link, it's been added as well. So we are ready to stream our data from Maya into UE4. So how can we preview this? If we come into UE4 and open our Skeletal Mesh now, once we open this up, we can come to the Preview Scenes Settings tab over here. And under Preview Controller, we can use the Live Link Preview Controller. Okay, it's going to ask for a subject name, which is the name of our character, which we called Feng Mao, like so. And we have the ability to enable camera sync. Okay, so if we enable this option, our camera is going to update to reflect our camera inside of Maya. So I'm now controlling the camera inside of UE4 by controlling it inside of Maya. So now we can work directly inside of Maya and see the updates made on our character in UE4. But there is one thing that we may notice is that our character is not taking the same pose as our character inside of Maya, and there's a reason behind this. If we look at the skeleton asset inside of UE4, we can see that the bone hierarchy and information is a little bit different than the naming convention inside of Maya. So in UE4, everything's root, pelvis, et cetera. But over in Maya, everything's prefixed by the term arcblade, colon, root, arcblade, colon, pelvis. So we give you the ability to retranslate those names into something compatible with the UE4 skeleton. So we're going to need to do that so that we can recognize the hierarchy information and the joint location from Maya in UE4. So we're going to show you how to do that real quick. And what we're going to need to do is create a new blueprint, which is our visual scripting system inside of UE4, by right-clicking and going to Blueprint. And we're looking for a live link remap asset. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select that. And we'll just give it something a little bit more descriptive. We'll just call it Feng Mao remap, like so. And once we open this up, this is our blueprint editor here. This may not be what you signed up for, so we're going to quickly get in here, make one change, and then we're going to get out. All we need to do is come up to the functions section and override a function called get remapped bone name. Okay, so it's going to take in the source, allow us to rename it, and translate it to our UE4 skeleton. Okay, so if we click on that, all we're going to use is a split node. Okay. And what the split node is going to do is it's going to read a source string, allow us to enter a character to search and split at, which is going to be the colon, and then everything to the right of that is all that we care about. So it'll convert everything to match our UE4 skeleton. So I'll take the bone name here and just plug that into the source string. It's going to give us a conversion node for us automatically. Can add a colon. Everything to the right of that is all we care about. I'm going to plug that in, like so. And that's all we're going to do. We're going to compile and we're going to close this. And if we go back to our skeletal mesh here, under retarget asset, we can assign that asset that we just created called Feng Mao remap. And our character is now going to update to reflect our character inside of Maya as we would expect. Okay, now the other thing that's interesting to note is because our character has physical properties assigned to it, you can see its chains, the chains kind of dangling and moving around. All the bits of his garb are kind of dangling around as well. So we can preview this in real time as well, which is pretty cool. So we've got the ability to preview content from Maya inside of UE4 in real time. What else can we do with this feature? This is all fine and dandy for previewing, but suppose we wanted to see this at runtime while our game is actually running. We give you the ability to do that as well with the help of an animation blueprint. Okay, so if we go to our skeletal mesh here and we right-click on it and we create an anim blueprint from it, just use the default name is fine. This is what is determining the pose that our characters enters frame by frame at runtime. So whatever feeds into here is going to be our final pose, as the name suggests here. So if I right click and I search for live link, or just live, we have a live link pose node, which we can use. If we connect this up, it gives us an out pose. We're going to connect that to the final animation pose. And we need to define the subject name, which we've done earlier in the session, which is just the name of our character called Feng Mao. The last thing that we need to do is for the live link pose node itself, over in the details panel, we need to assign that retarget asset that we created. So we can click the drop down and assign that Feng Mao remap, like so. And once we compile, you can see that our character updates to take our pose, and we could still control it. What we could also do, if I zoom in just a little bit here on his face, we could even change parameters. So I can come in here to the face and, for example, open that up. We can see that reflected on our character. Or we could keyframe different parts of the animation, test it out, see what it looks like before we go through that import-export process. So now that we have this animation blueprint, because it is an animation blueprint, we can assign this to any characters that we have in the level if we want to see those animations running while our game is running. Or we could take the animation blueprint and just drop it directly in the level like so. If we center them up on this platform a little bit and we play in the editor, so we're now running our game, we could still control it while our game is running from Maya. And what's even more interesting is that we can interact with objects in the world. For some reason, guys are falling from the sky there. But we can interact with them, which is kind of cool. So what else can we do with this? Suppose we had a cinematic and we had a motion capture actor that we wanted to provide the actual data streamed into the engine. We mentioned that you can use a motion capture as a source for live link. I have a quick cinematic here. It's not the fanciest, but if I enable it and we play, we have a cinematic now that is being played out, but we can still control it from an external source. We're controlling it through Maya, but we could control it from any other valid source that the live link responds to. Pretty neat. One of the other things that you could do, you could also, since this is an actor, you could use our sequence recorder to record all of the actions that we're doing. So we have this actor selected. If we go to Window and enable Sequence Recorder, with it selected, I could add that as a valid source to record. And if I start recording and I play, Wait, let's delete that. Let's make sure we turn off our cinematic first, because that would probably help. Turn this off. There we go. Let's try that again. So let's go ahead and stop that and record. So it's now recording everything that we're doing. It's recording this animation that I'm playing back here. If I were to stop and stop the session, you can see it's recorded a new sequence for us right here. And if we hide our existing skeletal mesh, this is the one that was actually recorded. So if I just play it, it recorded everything that we just did as well, which is pretty interesting. In fact, if I browse to this asset by right-clicking on it, going to Properties, and browse to it, it's an actual animation sequence now that's inside the engine. Now, there is some caveats to this. It will largely depend on your live link connection status. If there's any judder in the live link connection, you would see that reflected inside of the animation that we recorded, obviously. So use that sparingly. It is a quick way to get content into the engine, but use it sparingly. So wanted to close really quickly here talking about some of the other things that you could do. Plugin development. Right now we support the My AliveLink plugin, obviously, and the Motion Builder will be available via our launcher relatively soon. But you can also extend this to other applications in two different ways. The first would be building an Unreal Engine plugin that exposes a new source to the AliveLink client. This is the recommended approach if you have your own streaming protocol, such as motion capture servers. Or the second method would be integrating a message bus endpoint in a third-party application, similar to what we did with Maya and Motion Builder. You can kind of see the overview of the flow of how things are working here. All of this is covered and more on our official documentation pages regarding the Live Link feature, including everything that we went through today to give you a refresher. So really quickly, recapping here before we get out of here, what is Live Link? That's what we talked about, the feature, and how it could be used to give you more time to iterate on your content and less time importing and exporting that content. We talked about the Live Link client, which are sources and subjects that are managed by the Live Link client. Showed you how to enable Live Link in UE4 as well as in Maya. We established a connection between Maya and UE4 and set up some real-time bone remapping in the event that your naming conventions are a little bit different from Maya and UE4. We were able to preview our content from Maya inside of UE4 in real time, and also to make changes to our content in Maya and see those updated in real time as well. Talked about some of the additional use cases for Live Link and a little bit about plugin development. Again, feel free to check out our docs pages for more information. That's all the time I have. Thank you guys so much for sticking around for this talk. If you guys have any questions, feel free to grab me. I'll be over by the side. Thank you again.